Your tour guide is on her way, and my little earpiece is telling me she's going to be here soon. Is she here? Is Jennifer here? Jennifer?
Yeah.
Jennifer! I've got the audience here by Gandhi, is yours?
Sorry about that, yeah, I was a bit hungry. Can you not just wait a second? Well, you're gonna have to, yeah?
No?
Gandhi? Today is National Positivity Day. Nothing can go wrong. You get me, bro? Man. Victoria? Where you at, though? No, fam. I'm just gonna wave my flag, yeah? If you can see me, then come, yeah?
Where you at?
I'm at the Gandhi statue. Oh, where you been hiding, yeah?
Jesus!
It's been a long time. What's going on?
I didn't sign up for this, yeah?
Why is it like 500 people? Okay, Jesus Christ, more like 1,000.
Oh, man.
Jennifer, I think we need to like call the excuse.
All right, yeah, I'm just gonna go now.
Jennifer, what are you doing?
I'm just gonna go now.
Jennifer, remember that time?
Victoria, remember that time?
Jennifer. It's funny for life.
Yeah, I know, man.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Gentlemen. And ladies,
today is the day
your life is gonna change.
But first,
let's put that aside and introduce yourself.
I'm Victoria.
I'm Jennifer.
And together we are
Vicky
and Jamie.
Vicky,
guys, come on, clap. I'm feeling a beat. I'm feeling a beat.
Oh,
yeah. Oh. Look, Vicky and Jamie.
Yeah. You're funny.
I'm funny, yeah.
You know what the streets are about?
Of course you don't.
Obviously doesn't. But by the end of today, they're gonna know everything they need to know about this glue. Why have you got your walkie-talkie on the floor?
Oh.
Can you pick that up? That's got nothing to do with the museum. Pick it up,
oh,
please.
Oh, okay.
It's kind of embarrassing.
Yeah.
Okay, then.
Okay, if you...
Get my flag.
You sir, can you hold my flag for me, yeah? Okay. Cheers,
you,
bro.
Please, madame, please.
And can I just...
If you'd like to all follow us!
Cheers. Because today
is National Positivity Day.
And what does that mean, Victoria?
That means every single one of you are going to be positive for the day.
You know, like, just step back, just admire, look at the building, look at it. For 10 seconds.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Good.
Yeah, that was good.
Did you all feel the positive vibe off the building?
Yeah.
Yes, they did. Yeah, they did.
Today,
you've just split with your boyfriend.
Assigned. You didn't have enough money for McDonald's breakfast, yeah?
Assigned. You having trouble at home?
They're gonna go, yeah? They're gonna get out of here.
Jenny, I think we should do that, you know, that exercise we do at home.
Victoria,
yeah.
So if you just want to stand in neutral,
you breathe in the positivity, and you let out the negativity.
Come on, everybody, do this.
But when you breathe the negativity, I go. Demonstrate.
Come on, everybody.
What we want you to do is this. But follow us.
Yeah.
Follow us.
The bag.
Where are we going, bro? Yeah. All of you are coming. What are you doing standing in the car? You and you, what's your name, sorry?
Shauna.
Shauna and? Shauna and Melissa, if you'd like to just make a bridge. We're gonna, all of you are gonna go under this bridge. This is the bridge where you rebirth.
Right. So rebirth into a positive person, yeah?
Demonstrate,
please.
And now we're going to keep it moving.
Victoria.
Moving.
Definitely.
Yes!
I like your connection, yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
Hey, you! What are you doing, man? What's that? Are
Hi.
Come on, you all gotta go underneath, yeah? Good. Yes. Well done, man. Well done.
Compensation. Bats.
Okay. She's got caught a giant. That was it.
Have a couple of games.
Yeah. Say something about the team.
Guys, you need to be over here.
Receiving a letter from a mysterious man. Marty McFly walks through the Streetlife Museum after receiving a letter from a mysterious man telling him to come to this location. On this day, signed a friend. Marty holds the letter in his hand. The surprising thing that went through Marty's mind was when the letter was sent. The letter was written and kept safe for 50 years. This didn't surprise Marty as much as it would a normal person, so he knew, even though he hadn't seen Doc for 3 years, he must be up to something. A mysterious but familiar sound is heard from the telephone box near where Marty stands.
I put it in with the colors and did.
Oh, great Scott, I thought the past changed.
No, don't worry.
Marty, something dreadful has happened to the future.
What's happened? Again? And what happened to the DeLorean?
Don't worry about that, Marty. Just an updated time machine. Apparently it changes my hair from black and give me long mutton chops or something. But apparently, that's weird. But Marty, there's too much negativity in 2015. People are using a thing called Book Face or Facebook. One or the other.
Doc, you were telling me you built a time machine out of a telephone box.
Yes, Marty! Out of a telephone box! I was gonna paint it blue, but apparently someone in the time space has already done that!
What happened?
Marty, people are no longer talking to each other anymore. People are no longer using face-to-face communication skills either. Marty, 2015 is in danger. It will be plunged into darkness if we don't do something about it.
Okay, let me get this straight. We have to go back to the future fix up all the negativity. Just like that.
Just like that, Marty! Just like that! Great Scott. I just realized now that it would be a more difficult task than I thought. More difficult than ones that we have done.
Doc, this is heavy.
Weight has nothing to do with this, Marty!
Oh, come on, Doc!
Marty! I'll show you what I mean. Follow me, Marty!
Fine.
Follow me! To 2050 National Positivity Day! Follow Marty! Take a cheat for two, Marty. Think we're here, Marty.
Was not a rough ride at all.
Oh, at least I didn't change your hair. Marty, look at this. It's 2015. Look at that. They're not even talking to us anymore.
They look all so miserable.
We will.
Okay. Apologize to the nice audience.
We're sorry. Yeah? We're sorry. Just roll with it, Marty.
Who's
just roll with it.
You got my flag, yeah?
Come on, guys. You like to follow me? This all starting. Can you get the audience picture? Ah! Can you just hang on a sec, yeah? You want to follow the flag, yeah?
Follow the flag.
Improvisations are 10 seconds long, they can do whatever they want with them. Yeah. So, would you like to pick out a scene?
Yeah. I'm ready for this, yeah.
Are you ready?
Go on, Jenny. Jenny, you got this.
Wrestling with Patrick Starr.
You have 10 seconds to do it. Let's go.
Patrick Starr is off SpongeBob, isn't it?
Yeah. Begin.
Come on in, Patrick. Do you want some, yeah? I'll give it you. Come on in.
Little.
Come on in.
Little.
Do you want some, yeah?
All right. Someone else?
Be brave. Do it. Just do it.
All right.
Really, though?
Yeah, really. Would you like to step out today? Would you like to go out? Come on. No? All right, next one. Look at that pick. This gentleman here. You can leave if you want.
Marty,
too fit to leave.
Katie Hopkins.
Okay, we got Katie Hopkins here. Oh. Hey! Katie Hopkins regretting calling her daughter India.
Who names a child country?
Really?
I like that.
Right, I'm not being funny or anything, but I didn't name my child after the country named child after my... Oh, I'm making no sense. I know what I mean.
Alright, next one.
No, I ain't got a fam. I don't know what Katie Hopkins is. What's Hopkins? Who's Hopkins?
Okay.
That's good improvisation, right?
Let's go to the back, England blue coat.
What you want about, fam? Can you just shut up?
No.
Okay, odd side effects from odd medication.
Odd side effects from odd medication.
Oh.
This should be good.
Yeah, it should be.
Hello. How are you? Don't worry. This isn't a side effect. Sneezing is.
Hey! Come on, step up.
Oh, Jenny, you alright? No. No, Jenny, you alright? Oh, shit!
This is a side effect as well.
Victoria, I don't know what I'm going
to do. One more. Come on, step up.
Jenny, you just like Max, come on. Stop it.
Anyone else? No, I'm brave enough. Okay! Losers.
Really?
Really, darling? You got an attitude, I don't like you.
I think you're fit.
Things you don't hear. What? What's the difference?
Okay. Things you don't hear a politician say. Things you don't hear a politician say.
I think I got one.
She got this.
Step up.
YOLO.
This year, guys, we're telling the truth.
For the people who have died during Afghanistan, they clearly did not get money on their life insurance.
Free money, no taxes.
Scotland's now independent!
Okay, we're gonna switch game and we're going to play. You can only answer with questions. Or you can only talk with questions. Yeah, your favourite. You can only talk with questions. You've got 10 seconds to do it.
I like this one. No, it's really good. Toy.
That's your favourite. Mm-hmm. Alright, you can only talk with questions.
Yeah, fam.
Cameraman.
Show it to the camera as well. If the camera can see it.
God. Useless. Eating Miley Cyrus's wrecking ball.
Jesus.
Oh!
That's
my girl.
Yeah.
You got 10 seconds.
It seems like there's more than one wrecking ball here. Is it actually a wrecking ball we are licking?
Why are you licking the wrecking ball?
Does this taste salty to you?
Is the salt real?
Am I good at twerking, yeah?
Oh, yeah, you get me.
What's she doing?
You know what
all
this
right,
is?
Stop. Something else. There's plenty to do with a wrecking ball.
Because you'd know, yeah?
Yeah. Alright, let's try to tap it. You and your friend. Take it. Come on, quick. We ain't got no time. I'm growing a beard.
Losing your glasses at Disneyland and you can't find your friends.
That happened to me once, yeah, so I know what it's like.
Where are my glasses?
Sir, are you okay?
Where are my glasses?
You do realize you're in Disneyland,
no,
right?
Come on, it's gonna step up. Look, he's gonna get.
Where are my glasses?
Okay, let's finish with this one. The last game we're going to be playing, you have to sing whilst you talk. So you're singing and you're talking at the same time.
G! Hello?
Alright. Come on, go, fast.
Oh, the lights are coming up.
Whoa!
Come on, I said no, we've got no time.
Throwing mobile phones.
Ah,
a cat. Who to what?
Dumbag, go on next. I need an assistant.
Shouting at an owl who took your bagel.
Shouting at an owl who took your bagel.
It's called a good one.
But remember, you have to sing. Ooh.
Why have you took my bagel?
Oh.
Please may I have it back?
Why did you trust this owl with your bagel?
My mouth.
You shared a bagel.
All right, that's Will. We all have all for today. Join us next week at Who's Line Is It. My name is Vicky G, and I've been your host.
Yeah. Okay, I'll take over now. Okay, my show.
back to follow me, guys. Follow the flag!
We are going to the south of the jet, yeah? Yeah!
Yeah, get me for it! Oh, Jenny, you want your walk? Come on, guys, a bit faster.
All the time, effort and pain we women put into our lives each and every single day.
We were beaten, starved, and mentally in a state of trauma.
We weren't living life. We were surviving.
You disrespect what we were fighting for.
How are we disrespecting you? That there, young lady, is a fine example. We women knew how to be polite, speak in a modest way, and respect others as a mutual person, using the correct manners we were taught. We not only respected ourselves, but we respected others and multiple other things in the way we looked, acted, and dressed. How does the way I dress show how much compassion and respect I have for people?
You women leave nothing to the imagination. When we were in the company of gentlemen, we would wear the appropriate attire. You show off your bodies like you're an exhibition.
Respect is reflected in all aspects of a person. You have to remember, my friend, we gave them the freedom to choose their own lifestyles. And if they choose to shame us, bare their skin, and flirt with men, it's their right. We should be proud that we're in today's society, get to experience all the joys that we couldn't.
But were the hours of us chaining ourselves to the gates of Parliament, being heckled by policemen, watching our friends die and being spat on by men, really worth women in today's society dragging the word women through the dirt?
You have a point. However, we fought to love ourselves and be proud of that. Isn't that what they're doing? A feminist, a person who believes in the political, economic equality of the sexes.
Though we have courage to raise our daughters like our sons, we rarely have the courage to raise our sons like our daughters.
For us, women, we have been taught that the earth is flat, and if we venture far, we will fall off the edge.
Please.
Shh. Courage calls to courage everywhere, and its voice cannot be denied.
Well done!
Right, need to
Break the ice, Teeth, break the ice. Break it with a jerk. What was that jerk off the flour the other day? Something about beating it with a sandwich. That was it. Give me all your money or I'll hit you with my ciabatta. You beget me. I think that was it.
Anna?
Oh my God, Sarah!
Hi!
Hi!
So how are you?
I'm fine, I'm really good. Yeah? How about you?
I'm never better. So where are you going? Anywhere nice?
I'm starting university.
Me too! Which one are you going to? And what are you studying?
I'm gonna go to London Metropolitan.
Oh wow, that is amazing! Yeah. And in London?
Yeah, psychology I'm doing, yeah.
Oh, that's great.
Where are you going?
To Manchester, to do business.
Great. Well, I'm not surprised you're doing business, to be honest. I mean, he was always money-oriented.
Oh, I know.
What was that time? You found 20 quid in primary, didn't you?
Yes, I did, and I thought I was the richest girl in the world.
Yeah. When are you going to buy, like, tutus and bubbles and all of that? And then the teaching major handed it back in.
I'm pretty sure
I pocketed it himself, though.
He must have done.
Yeah. Sue, you excited?
Yes, I am. Are you?
I am. I'm sort of nervous.
Why?
Well, because there's going to be new people I'll be meeting, and it's like, I don't know whether they're going to like me or hate me.
Yeah.
And then leave my mum as well, even with her hearing problem.
I know about your mum.
Yeah. I just don't know what she's going to do, you know, like if there's a knock at the door or, you know, if she goes to the shops.
Anna, I understand what you're talking about, but I'm sure your mother will be fine while you're in London.
Yeah.
Is anyone looking after her while you're away?
Yeah, my uncle Gavin is here.
Well, that's a good thing. At least she's not going to be alone. I've got a problem too, you know.
Why? What's up?
You know Justin, my boyfriend.
Six-pack Justin?
Actually, it's eight-pack Justin now.
Lucky cow.
Yeah. Justin doesn't want me to go all the way to Manchester for my degree.
Well, why not?
Just because of the fact that I'm leaving home. And it's like, I'm not going to see him again.
Ugh. Why do men always exaggerate? Have they never heard of a bloody train?
I don't know. And it's not just that. He's worried that I'm going to meet someone new there.
Well, to be honest with you, no offence, but he has got the personality of a wet mop. And okay. You're gorgeous, so, you know, it probably will happen.
But if I meet someone in Manchester, that's going to affect our relationship.
Oh, yeah, if you meet someone else, I'm pretty sure that means you broke up.
But you know that me and Justin are strong, and we're going to get through this.
Yeah, of course.
And why would anyone hate you? You're a great person.
Well, I try, but I know it can be annoying sometimes.
We can all be annoying sometimes, but you're not annoying.
Well, some people at college found me annoying.
And some people found you amazing.
Really?
Yes. I wouldn't worry if I was you.
I need your advice. How do I make people like me? I don't know what to do.
Anna, don't try to make people like you. Just act positive and feel confident in front of the people you meet there.
You've got a point. That's made me feel a bit better, thanks, hon.
Trust me, you'll be fine in London.
I hope so.
And plus, you might not like them.
True, I mean, that accent can be annoying. It could be like living with the Artful Dodger.
Oh, God, yeah, it would.
I've seen all of them.
Yes, me too. Consider yourself.
Yeah, that was a good song.
Yes, it was.
Sue.
Anna! Do you remember that party at Peter's house last year?
Don't get me started. I still have a hangover thinking about it.
How many shots did we have?
I think it was like 10 each.
Oh no, not 10.
Yeah. I can't remember. I don't know if we drank that much. But to be honest.
But only one thing that I remember though is Justin putting that song on. What is it called?
Oh, I know what you mean.
It was on Despicable Me.
Yeah, it was.
Gru, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Minions, people, people.
That was a good impression of a minion.
Was it?
Yeah.
God, what was it? Something about being positive.
Is it Happy by Pharrell Williams?
That's it, yeah.
Yeah.
There was all like standing in lines, like swaying, like yeah. Gospel choir.
Yes, we was. Like, just like in the video.
Yeah. Because I'm happy, come along if you feel like a wrong way down. Hey, 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 cause I'm happy, come along if you feel like happiness in you. Breathe aloud!
We've just done this in a train station.
Oh, yeah.
Awkward. And what about the wine that we drank as well?
Oh, £1.99 special from Home Bargains. Petrol!
I did not like that wine.
No. Tasted awful.
It did. Anna, do you want to get a coffee while your train arrives?
Yeah, it'd be great, yeah.
My train's here, Duck. I'm gonna have to get going.
Oh, has it?
Yeah.
I'm just gonna get a coffee well away from my train.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a long while.
Caffeine boost.
Yes, we all need that caffeine boost.
Yeah, come here.
Have fun in London.
Yeah, you too. Manchester won't know what's it.
Well, we all know that's true. And if you ever fancy leaving the bright lights of London and slumming it up in Manchester for the weekend, just let me know.
Yeah, well, yeah. I think I have you on Twitter.
Or no, it's Facebook.
Facebook.
Yeah, it's Facebook, yeah.
I'll inbox you, all right?
Oh, okay, go for it.
All right, see you later.
Good luck.
Marty, I believe now is the time we do what we came here to do in the first place before we got dragged into this. Do you have any ideas what we could do, Marty?
Actually, I have a great plan. What if we get them to help us fix the future without... You know, messing with space-time continuum.
That's a brilliant idea, Marty. See, now you're getting the hang of this timey-wimey stuff.
Yeah.
Well, since you've done this about, what, three times?
About three times.
I'll let you do the talking now this time. Be careful, they may now think we're weird.
Why?
Well, I'm like 85 years old, wearing a lab coat in the middle of the museum, and you're wearing a jacket that think... You may need drowning or helping being drowned, or whatever. Mind, space, time, continuum. The whole thing's a mess. People think you're drowning, you need help.
Don't worry, Doctor, I've got this.
Be careful, Marty.
Hey.
Hiya.
How are you?
I'm alright, thanks. How are you?
Good.
Marty?
What?
Remember what happened last time when you messed around with the opposite gender?
Oh, yeah. My mom.
That's right, your mom! You nearly even... did it.
Shut up.
That's the one time I will never forget that. Right, Marty. I guess I will do the talking, right?
Be my pleasure.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, men and women, and you. The message here I need to tell you all now. There's too much negative energy happening around you, around the out there, even on your phones and your devices. There's too much negativity energy in those devices. And I can see you looking for your phone, thinking, is that true? Well, it is true. Negative energy, but there's positive energy too. But people don't use that positive energy. The positive energy, it's in here, that people need to bring out more often. Or sometimes. But use it and bring it out. Push the negative aside before, like Facebook or Bookface, you'll become light into the darkness. I think they may know what to say to Marty.
Yeah, I don't have a clue what you're all about.
You don't, Marty. But they do. Now, I believe right now, at this time and the wind, they need to go to the chemist, Marty. But where we go into the chemist, we don't need roads.
Doc, what are you looking at?
This train looks like mine. If I faced out there for a second. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, come on, follow me.
such.
To the chemist! No need to be afraid! To the chemist we go! Quiet, everyone.
Coming, guys!
Come on, you're late.
It's going to be a tight here, so let's all try to get in. Everyone come in.
You alright there?
If you can't see, you'll be able to hear. It's all about hearing. Come in, guys.
And listening.
We said no camera. Come in, guys. Come on, don't be afraid. Come on. Fill this space up.
Come on. We don't come hurt, on. You know.
Right. Is everyone up?
There is a German satellite falling to Earth. She says, what if it hits me? Welcome to Anxiety Group, the kingdom of the sweaty palm and the jiggling legs where the women wrap themselves up tight where the men bite nails till blood. There is no pride here. We lack the discipline of the eating disorder group, lack the self-righteousness of bereavement group, and we're not as fun as Procrastinators Anonymous. Nobody wants to be here. Me, I don't sleep, can't sleep. I make insomnia look professional, make your tossing and turning look like afternoon hiccups. The longest I've gone is 9 days, went literally insane. Sleep deprivation is a form of torture, you know, and I do this to myself. Melatonin makes me sad. Benadryl is for amateurs. Hypnotics turn off the lights too quickly. And weed makes me crazy. Diazepam, bromazepam, Klonopin is the only thing that works, and they're weaning me off it. So, like a baby forced to remove breast from mouth, take bottle instead. I got sent to anxiety group, and apparently we're all going to die because while the girl to my left worries that the satellite will hit her, the woman to my right worries that it will hit a nuclear power plant, and then we're all stuffed. My father said, only rich people go to therapy, poor people got stuff to do, and yet here I am, in this lifeboat surrounded by 8 of the most beautiful, crazy-ass people this world has ever seen.
Some people might want to get stuff off their chest.
Do you want to get anything off your chest?
I'm fine.
Wait.
Do you have anything to say?
Yeah.
Go on then. Ready? Do you want to hurry up?
I'm just thinking, can you wait a second, bro?
Don't have any knickers on.
That really wasn't relevant.
Okay. Do you have anything to get off your chest?
Nope. Anything to get off your chest? Come on.
I'm fine.
I feel like everyone's positive in here. I feel like
we've done a good job. You've done a good job.
I feel like you've changed everyone in here.
Do you have anything to get off your chest, madam?
I think I've said it all.
Exactly. So moving on swiftly then.
I think we should move on. If everyone would like to slowly abort,
it just ran the corner down the street.
You got. What are you looking at?
Mm-hmm. You got.
Sorry.
Maybe wiring on predisposition played God.
England, brace to face what we don't know. God loves all his children, some have forgotten. Her face a book written 3,500 years ago, and I don't know. And I can't change, even if I tried, even if I wanted to. And I can't change, even if I tried, even if I wanted to. My love, my love, my love, she keeps me warm, she keeps me warm, she keeps me warm, she keeps me warm. If I was gay, I think hip-hop hates me. You read the YouTube comments lately. Man is gay, it's dropped on the daily. Comes from under what we're saying. Culture founded from oppression, yet we have acceptance for. Call each other famous behind the keys and message board. We're rooted in hate, yet a genre still ignores it. Gay as anonymous with the lesson. Same hate that's caused wars from religion, gender to skin color, the complexion of your pigment. Same fights that people walk out and sit in. It's human rights for everyone, there is no difference. Live on, be yourself. When I was in church, they told me something else. Keep each hate of the service, those words are unanointed. Holy water, juice soaking, it's been poisoned. When hope someone's brother, when they're voiceless. That's not important. No freedom till we're equal. Dynamite, I support it. I don't know. And I can't change, even if I try, even if I wanted to. My love, my love, my love, she keeps me warm, she keeps me warm, she keeps me warm. Press play, no press pause, progress, march on. With the velvet our eyes, we turn our back on the course. Till the day my moms could be united by law. Kids are walking around the hallways, played by pain in their hearts. World so hateful, someone died, don't know who they are. Certificate on paper, it isn't gonna solve it all, but it's a damn good place to start. Law is gonna change us, we have to change us. Whatever God you believe in, we come from the same one. Strip away the fear underneath, it's all the same love. It's about time we raised up. I can't change, even if I tried, even if I wanted to. I can't change, even if try, even if I wanted to. My love, my love, my love, she keeps me warm, she keeps me warm, she keeps me warm, she keeps me warm. Love is patient, love is kind, love is patient. Love is kind, love is patient, love is kind.
Come on, hurry up, guys, come on! Come on, you're late!
Come on, guys, we haven't got all day, have we?
No. No, man.
Exactly. Gosh. Wasting my time. Can I all like to... There's a lot of you, so you're going to have to move in, please. So, budge a little.
Thanks.
I'm here, Jenny. Can you see me with the flag?
I see you, fam.
All right.
Okay, so embrace yourself, yeah, for something scary.
Joking.
Take it away, fam.
I am the one who keeps you awake at night. I am the one who makes your heart pound. It'll pound so fast until you can barely breathe. You're so choked up, you just want to leave. I am the one who gets inside your head. I am the one who makes you wish you were dead. I'll worm my way inside you and eat away at your brain. I will be the one to drive you insane. I'll beat you up mentally and rip you apart. You fall to the floor and just want to cry. You cry and cry and you ask yourself, why? Why are you doing this? Why me? Am I weird? Am I annoying? Am I a freak? Why? Please tell me, why don't you like me? I'll make you question your health. You'll think you're ill. You'll think you're a screw-up. Well, guess what? You are. You don't need friends. You've got me. I'll be your friend. I'll look after you. And I'll be with you until the end. So come on, what are you waiting for? Take my hand and follow me. Are you ready to jump in 1, 2, 3? Wait!
What are you doing? Step away from the ledge. It really isn't worth it. It doesn't have to end this way. Don't be afraid, smile. Everything will be okay. So what? A few kids are calling you names. So what? People don't think you're cool. Fat, thin, short, or tall, it really shouldn't matter at all. You may feel alone right now, but I promise you, you're not. You've got people who care and people who love you. I know it may not seem like it right now, but they always have and they always will. Just imagine what it would do to your family and friends. It would tear them apart. You need to know that everything is going to be all right and that this pain won't last forever because it will get better, I promise you. Everyone needs a friend. Well, you've got me. I'll be your friend. I'll look after you and I'll be with you until the end. So take my hand, please. Don't worry. You will always have a friend in me. Woo!
Woo! See you guys.
Well done. Should appreciate the friends you have.
I appreciate you, Jennifer.
Yes, fam.
Please, after the night, squeeze through. That would be amazing. Okay, so the next place we're going to is a tree. Yeah?
Oh, a tree?
Yeah,
a tree.
Guys,
follow
me. We're going to go back to some nature.
Please, so you got that.
All right, Jenny. All right, that's it.
David Attenborough. Welcome to Teen Wildlife. In this episode, I am in the Street Life Museum, observing Homo sapiens, or humans, as some people know them as. I have tracked down a teen to this location to study his behavior and the way he moves around the museum. Oh, now the teen is coming. Now I must hide.
Hello.
Hi.
See how Paul greets Stevie calmly in order to gain the trust of a female.
Did you hear something?
I think so.
Teen seems to be growing aware of my presence. I may need to make my location less conspicuous.
Who is that?
I haven't a clue. Hello? Hello?
They seem to have spotted me. Oh no.
What's he doing?
Okay, in order to get out of here safely, I must quickly think of a clever and complicated way to escape these teenagers.
Swapsies with me!
What?
Swapsies!
Success!
Well, at least he's out of the way.
He was kind of freaky.
Yeah. What are you doing?
Leeds, you.
Sir.
I'm Stevie, by the way.
I'm Paul. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
They have introduced themselves to each other in order to gain each other's trust. Now, I'm going to wait and see what they do next.
Are you still here?
Paul is attempting to communicate with me. I'll try to respond. Hello, Paul.
Hi. Who are you?
Paul is trying to identify me to decide whether I'm a threat or not. My name is David Attenborough.
Can you go where?
Paul seems to be getting angered by my presence. I may need to be more cautious of what I say and do.
What are you doing anyway?
I'm here to study the behaviour and movements of teenagers such as yourselves. Just continue to talk normally, pretend I'm not here.
What brings you to Leeds?
Starting university. You?
I've got a new job.
Paul is trying to make it look like he has money. Enough. Enough to take on a date. Paul seems to, as the teens say, have the hots for her.
Is that true?
Kind of, yeah. Do you want to get a coffee?
I'd love to.
Cool. Paul seems to want to mate with the female. By the looks of the female, he's got no chance.
What?
This ends another episode of Teen Wildlife. Coming next week, I'll be observing teen behaviour at a local cinema. There, I'll hopefully find more teens on dates, with friends, or just loners with nothing to do. See you then.
Come along, everyone!
Sorry, is everybody feeling on that?
Yeah, Nana! Come on!
What?
What? You done?
Yeah, take it away.
Alright, okay. I never liked the outside. I felt every single eye of every single person mentally tear me apart. So, I stopped going outside. I stopped putting myself through that physical and mental pain.
Depending on the technical difficulty.
where am I standing?
Stand on the leg, go into the comms, please.
Keep moving down the aisle. Stand up. Is it now?
Is it now?
Is it?
How about now?
I'm not sure, the audience here.
I'm scared, you're sick of me.
Oh wait. Come here.
Well, it started.
How positive or negative they really are. This is why we are here today to show you. Yeah?
This is my land.
You're speaking far too slow.
No, I wasn't.
You was.
Wasn't.
You was.
Wasn't.
Anyway, here are some examples of positive friends. Look at me looking at the camera again, let's just hope I don't fall over. Hello and welcome to the Great British Bake Off.
We have 10 bakers.
And today we're going to be baking us a lemon meringue pie. Oh.
Get ready.
Get set. Bake.
Saturday
Night Takeaway.
We are the only TV show on
television.
Watch the advert.
Winner! And now Nick. Oh my God. As if I had to stay in a house with that.
As if you call your child India. Really?
Hello and welcome to I'm okay and you're not as good as us.
No, me.
No, us.
Me.
No, the show's called I'm okay and you're not as good as us.
Me.
Why do you all have to start an argument?
Just me, innit?
Do you know what?
What?
I'm ending the show right now.
Go for maybe a one-woman show then, Martin.
I can't even believe that we have to work together. I swear it's all your fault.
Your fault.
Your fault.
Your fault. Me and him.
Positive version. Hello and welcome to I'm Okay and You're Not As Good As. Right, shall we start with a warm up?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
There we go. You ready? What's that warm up that you're doing again? Plunge. No, seriously, what's that warm up like doing again?
Something squat.
You know how to do it, yeah?
Yeah,
the positivity squats.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, do an explain.
Yeah. Basically, what you have to do is do a squat and say something positive about yourself. Let them do it.
Of course I would. Funny.
Optimistic.
Yeah, shall we go on together?
Yeah.
Inspiring. Right now we need two volunteers.
Get some of these from the back.
So come on. I do a positive squat.
Those
who are walking off. Come on.
Come on.
You drag yourself in now.
Be ashamed to cry. Let me see you.
friends with this one.
Self-destruction mode. Teenagers today fantasize about death on a regular basis. Eating disorders, for example. You lose weight at a drastically healthy rate. You reverse your body's natural systems by making yourself sick. How is that helping us survive? People smoke and take drugs to fit in. All we're doing is destroying ourselves for short-lived moments of joy. In 2012, 5,981 people committed suicide in the UK alone. How many people tried but didn't succeed? When did life become so negative that we'd rather die than focus on getting better? I'm not going to tell you everything's going to be okay, and I'm not going to tell you everything's going to be fine. Life's one hell of a journey with bumps in the road, both big and small. But we have to learn to balance out the bad and the good. No life's full of negatives. It always has some form of positive moments in it. Maybe it'd be the best thing in the world to go back in time and start it all again. But maybe the reason time travel isn't real is because we're meant to grow and learn, not cower and hide.
Yeah! Oh, can't woman, my child.
By the way, yeah, there's about 20 seats, so I don't think all you're going to get in yet.
So basically, the chosen ones can only go in there, so it can't be like wrong.
If that was you, I'd best behave.
Oh, I'm
yeah, get me, bro! You're getting me, bro.
Ladies and gentlemen, are we all settled? Allow me to introduce you to the place of Nirvana, where no demons can come. Release yourself in the sound of music and enjoy our adventure. Now, we have a very special guest here with us tonight. We have a corporal damaged by the war. Now, would you like to tell us about your story?
My name's Corporal William Perkins, and I just come back from Vietnam. But there's something I need to tell you today. You see, I love war. Yes, I love shooting people, and I love killing people. Because that's just what I love. Welcome to the love.
Repetition is the definition of a soldier man. They just wanted to tie him up and snap him like a rubber band. Back in Vietnam, the youth to say, now what is the plan? He said he never trust a man unless he Russell Brand. Now pass him all the apps in for now, watching James and Jackson. He got girls in the back of the mattress, you got girls in the map, like that's it. They wanna know if I killed one or shot one, hurt one or lynched one, all the way back in Vietnam now.
Touch me, touch
me. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Blue. Like the colour of the sky. Now, sadly, when I was younger, my parents died in a car crash, evidently. It was on the way back from the 25th anniversary. Babysitter fell on the Lego, broke her ankle. They had to come home early. And now, since that day, I've done nothing but live my life in the pity of only having myself to blame for my parents' death.
It's not your fault.
I was stupid enough to turn to drugs.
Drugs are bad.
But then all of a sudden, two guys from the future comes and tells you of a girl called Miley Cyrus. Yes. And then I realised there was much more worse off people in this world than myself. I mean, this twerking thing. If anything, it's just discriminating women's rights.
It looks like you're farting and you're trying to back it up. You know, trying to get rid of the smell.
Anyways, I'm gonna stop talking. I'll leave you over.
Corporal, you have been damaged. You've been broken. Your soul is snapped and you look pale as a sheet. You need some colour in you and stuff. We'll just stand up for you, please. I'm going to read you a little thing that maybe might change your mind on how to think differently, not killing.
Figure it out!
Talk, not spit. Okay. Every situation, every goal, every milestone is accomplished with a fight. You know. And a person has to remain firm-footed till he their pious conscience is satisfied.
Put your demons away. Stay calm.
Okay, I think we should have to cut this short exorcism, okay? Sit down.
Let's give this man some energy.
Be healed. Be healed!
Release your demons! Have we done it?
We've done it.
Have we done it?
We've done it.
Corporal. Corporal. Corporal.
Get up. Get up. Come on. You can do it.
Stand, boy.
You can do it. Okay, you do it. He's heavy.
Let's change this, man.
Change his mind. Let's sing a song.
Let's
sing a song.
Do you want to be a punk rocker?
Do I?
Let's be punk rockers.
I want to be a punk rocker.
Get on it.
Okay. I wrote this when I was one day walking through to Tesco's and things happened and yeah. Awful things. Okay. Oh, I wish I was born back in the 70s or 80s, when there wasn't any stupid Facebook feeds or Twitter needs. I was born in a world with too many problems. Oh, I wish I was a punk rocker with flowers in my hair. 5, 6, 7, and now we have too many tools and kids are being complete fools. Why can't we pay more attention? Can they write to me? Oh, I wish I was punk rocker with flowers in my hair. Where I wasn't receiving any final requests, can decently stop it, please. I just want a black and peanut tax hair. Oh, I wish I was punk rocker with flowers in my hair. And MySpace is history. I felt like my life was in jeopardy. And I'm going to communicate with Ryan 1-3. And mom and dad were in their teens, and Anakin was still a dream. And the only way to get in touch with a letter in the mail. Oh, I wish I was a punk rocker with flowers in my hair. In 77 and 69, revolution was in the air. I was born to a world that doesn't care. Oh, I wish I was a punk rocker with flowers in my hair. I was born too late into a world that doesn't care. I wish I was a punk rocker with flowers in my hair. Woo!
Now, I'm going to leave you feeling positive and fresh to make you feel better about yourself. So we're going to take some deep breaths and exhale it all. Just get it all out. Okay? So breathe in.
Every gorilla nostrils release the energy out.
And I want a lion roar. 3, 2, 1, roar! 3, 2, 1, roar!
And one more tap to this side. Roar!
Don't you feel better? Thank you. Well, thanks for listening, guys.
Okay, thank you. Now we give your attention to...
Now, guys, it's your time to shine. Do it. Do the message.
In the
dark. We can do it.
Marty, what are you doing?
We came here to change things, and we can send them on the right path.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Marty McFly, and some people would say I'm new and not from around here. But I've learned a lesson today, is that with self-confidence and self-belief, you can achieve anything you set out to do. I've enjoyed being here, but I also learned that being a teenager is hard, and you're set with many challenges. For example, singing, something I've always dreamed of doing, but never had the confidence to do it myself. I came here today to change things. Doc and I, we had a plan to change the future, to make the world a better place.
We need to change the future. This is serious, guys. Let him speak.
And it also shows that no matter who you are or what you're going through, you just have to be yourself, and like will attract to like. For example, this is Doc. He's old, but he's my friend. He may not even be conventional, but he's my best friend. and my only friend. But that's okay. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to dedicate my first ever public performance to all you beautiful people in this room, and also Doc. A great man once said, "I have great faith in fools. Self-confidence, my friends will call it, as Mr. Edgar Allan Poe. If any of you know the words, you can join in. I'm going once round." Wish you would step back from that ledge, my friend. Could cut ties with all the lies that you've been living in. And if you never want to see me again, I would understand. I would understand. I sing over a secret pain. You know you don't belong. Cause everyone I know has got a reason to say, you can put the past away. Wish you would step up from that ledge, my friend. Yeah. Cut ties of all the lies that you've been living in. And if you never want to see me again, I would understand. I would understand. I would understand.
Two more times.
I would understand. I would understand.
For the grand finale, I know you're all excited. Don't worry. Follow the flag.
Thank you.
Yeah.